Dylan Hill's back in the booth. Kevin Ford here with me. Wow, here we've got Gunnar Miller facing off against Cabana again in the first part of this triathlon match. I've got to say, Gunnar Miller, a huge pickup by the 1%. I'm shocked with a fellow Chattanoogan, a 4-2-3-er along with Gunnar Miller. I was not expecting him to be a member of the 1%, but they have hired a strong hand.
Yeah, they didn't show their hand until this evening. We were wondering who was going to be. We know the young line Alexander Eugene is still on excursion in Germany, wondering who that third partner was going to be. And they did quite a coup. A man who decimated Tim Donson last month. Gunnar Miller making a big impression in his debut match, and it seems like the 1% was paying attention. And this is a triathlon match, as you said. Sage Phillips, who technically pinned Logan Isolero last month in the Peter Brown Ultra Day Championship contest, has both recruited teams of three. This is a 2 out of 3 falls match, where the first fall is a singles competition, the second is a tag team match, and if it goes to a third fall, it's all three members of each team will compete in a trios match.
Approach has been a little bit confounding, but Gunnar Miller's so strong, he's so fast. He had a bit of a choke there, he just throws him off.
Well, I like the strategy of, I mean, anybody against Gunnar Miller is going to have a size advantage here, but I've seen Cabana Mandan compete against larger opponents, and he has the veteran prowess of anybody on Sage's team.
Well, he's been around for a long time, but he might have been inside going back many years. Oh my god, he caught him. Oh! The snap on that release overhead, belly to belly, moving to the rope. Bobby Shields almost hitting the ring there. They're so jubilant.
Absolutely effortless throw by Gunnar Miller.
I mean, this guy holds the record at the University of Tennessee Chattanooga for the squat. At a linebacker, he holds that record, 610 pounds. And it's not 610 pounds. But he did just fly across the ring again.
Like a bag of moldy tangerines, he just threw him across the ring.
The community's calling for more pain to be inflicted on the
Cabana. Come on, Cabana.
A guy who's logged a lot of miles, definitely a talented wrestler. But Gunnar Miller's really just laying it in there.
Yeah, this has certainly been an uphill climb for Dan since the start.
Just the snap on that. You see guys, I just see a belly-to-belly or overhead throw. But how deep he gets and the angle on the release is so brutal. Hard to imagine how anybody can survive one, let alone three. Big credit to Cabana Mandan for even hanging in there at this stage.
No doubt about it. The fact that he's still conscious, let's be honest, is quite a miracle.
Miller just playing with him now. Sage Phillips and Ace Perry trying to get the crowd behind Cabana Mandan. Big shoulder to the gut. Remember, this is a former linebacker at the University of Tennessee, Chattanooga. If anybody's going to be able to utilize the shoulder tackle in any of its form, it's him.
And he's doing it in front of Sage and Ace to send a message.
Oh, that's logical. I mean, there's no question about it. Like, this is a guy who was, in fact, a captain on a football team. He's been a high-level athlete basically his entire life, really bred for this.
And now he's, I don't know if he's sold out or bought in, but now he's the corporate captain of all things. I guess it shows you everybody does indeed have a price.
I mean, I think he's almost begging Cabana Mandan to give him a little something, but. God.
And you know, there's a rare call in professional wrestling where the referee feels like one of the wrestlers is just doing damage and not trying to end the match. They can call for a disqualification. Gunnar has to be very careful that Todd Myers doesn't feel that he's exerting his aggression, he's doing excessive punishment, or else that could give Sage's team one fall.
He's not even going for a cover, but he just dropped him right on his head. Just dropped him on his head. Like it was nothing. That's a fourth suplex.
Well, and let's keep in mind, too, this doesn't just affect the first fall. If Sage had Cabana Mandan earmarked for the tag team match coming up, that could change his entire game plan. He might have put himself with Ace Perry in there instead.
This may not go to the trios match. We may not get that far. I mean,
if Gunnar Miller has his way, it sure as heck ain't.
Mean mugging these people in the front row.
Mr. Scenic City just sending a message to the 99%.
He jaw-jacked him.
Yeah, Axel and Jawjacker taking out the knee.
You know what? You get him down on the mat. You're all the same size down there.
Ooh, nice little kangaroo kick from Cabana Man Dan. Oh, he threw him up to his feet.
I think it's more of an annoyance.
Oh my goodness. like a flea bit him. Well, here we go. Here comes the flip-flop chop, I think, is what Dan needs to bust out here. Oh, he's pissed. Oh, God. And then you face him. What? What the hell?
It's not going to be pretty.
Oh, he got him in the face. Oh, my God. Oh,
wow. He got him good.
He got him last there. Dan is fired up.
Adam is resisting. Ooh, he just tossed him in the corner. He's right in those double knees. He's definitely got him on the edge. I'm surprised.
Oh, well, that's called high risk. Dan fought out again, using another knee, coming up the ropes. Pow!
Oh my God! He almost threw into the first row.
Oh my God, Cabana Man Dan might be dead.
His head rattled off the bottom rope. He can pin him now, but he wants to jackhammer him. He's honking him for good measure.
Again, sending a message to Ace and Sage. Jackhammer!
Yeah.
The first one.